Right, today I'm afforded the relative luxury, well, as I was yesterday, I was here for yesterday and most of today, fibreglassing these water rills, these sections, one, two, three, there's a few more down there. I just thought I'd show you how I do it. My glass is all cut to size, so we're going to be going down the sides like that. One across the middle, back up the other side, and up the end. Let's get some catalyst in, go 1%. These are for a display somewhere in London, I believe, for a company that does cosmetics. Basically, they're all going to be bolted together and silicone sealed at the joints and just have some water running through them. It's a very, very short-term use, namely a three-day exhibition. Timber out first. Tailor that little bit of a corner out. If you look at the very end of this, it's only holding literally not even 2 inches of water. But we're going to be glassing up to the top edge anyway. This is a 450 gram layer of glass. Now, if you're a GRP guy, you might have worked out the alternative way of doing this, and that is to put the floor on first and then use the side layers to mask over the flat line of that 450, but it's inconsequential. You can do it that way. But I'm just going to mush the, when it's nicely wet out, I'm just going to mush that line out so it's barely detectable. It's not overly important to do this, it's just good practice in making a nice job. Get right up into that top little rad. Bit early to fifth, messing about with it like that. Film this one because it's mildly interesting the way it curves around. Just show you how we tailor the glass to suit around that curve. These might not look like they've been primed with resin, but they were primed yesterday. Like I say, it's only a bit of a very short-term use, so priming it again, not exactly critical, just good practice when you're going over timber. Ring ring. Some interesting comments from the staff here at this factory about the smell of the fibreglass, how it stunk the old factory out and they've had to open doors and things. Right, I'm just going to put a little bit of a tear in that because we're coming around a bit of a radius, just to help it round a little bit. And others have said they like the smell of it. Someone yesterday said they'd got a headache and they were working way, way over that way. Nice and controlled, not slopping it all over the place. Now I'm going to want to put either a short piece in or tear one into half for this. There's one I've done earlier. See, that last one has just come round that edge a little bit, just the way I needed it. Might just get this out, that 5 kilo. Being really generous with this resin. It's not as if I'm on a gel coat on the other side and I've got to worry about the gel shrinking. Literally just smashing it on. Let's put that out of there because I've literally run out of room. Again, that can just tease that round that side. No, I'm going to need a tad more resin. Literally need a roller full of resin on that. Not worth running the risk of that, you know, not being wet enough. Don't want water all over the floor at the exhibition, do we? Induce some mild backache in a minute. So this is relative luxury, and I mean it is only relative. And as much as I'm not working outside in punishing heat and rain and worrying about a cover collapsing on me, just use that brush just to dab that glass into that radius, or those radii. come a bit high just there. Grind that off later. Just see a little bit of dry glass up there. Right, plenty of movement left in that, look. And then just paddle roll it out and check my hand's not all gunged up. Mush that line out that I talked about earlier. Again, it's not overly critical because it's going to be full of water, but when it dries to that opaque colour, want it looking at least half decent. Thank you. Actually, very little, almost no contact with that glass with my hands, just all done with the tools. Obviously, you've got to place it and tailor it. But as for running my finger along the radius to get the air out, no, then this is what this tool's for. Should get a better view of it there. Bit of light on it. No air left in that. Don't want to be forcing that roller right into that radius, because all you do is push the resin out, and you want resin there. Wet the resin, don't forget. And that's the waterproofing component of this system. And the fiberglass gives it that awesome strength that we know about. So we're not shy on resin, and we're not forcing it right out of that rad there. Leaning over and giving myself a backache for that, no thank you. I'll get underneath it afterwards and just check I've got all the way to the top. You literally do it by feel. See some people as well, sometimes they'll use the arm of the roller there and just do that, but sometimes you might do it, not on this particular radius. I don't want to be doing that. Thank you. Let's say if this job was on, let's say if this timber was a component for a boat and they were concerned about the weight of it, you might want to take the surface, take the excess resin off the surface, and all you do is just basically wring the roller out and roll it over it dry. No requirement on this, just thought I'd mention it. Or if you're making anything, you know, lightweight. Three more of these to do and I'm done. Yeah, all good. Happy at that. Let's get these tools cleaned out. Thank you.